This video is for all of you applying for the student visa to the US. We are going to discuss what are the most common reasons why these visas get rejected and also how you can avoid them. Keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi. I'm a travel and a visa coach, and on this channel you'll find tons of useful videos on the US visa process, right from filling the form to clearing the interview. Make sure that you check it out. This video, we're going to talk about the rejection reasons for F1 visa interviews. I think there cannot be a worse feeling than getting into the college of your dreams, doing all the hard work, you know, putting in all the effort and the time, and then not being able to go because your visa got rejected. I'm here to tell you that this is something which you can totally avoid with a little bit of planning and loads of preparation and practice. So we already have one more video on the channel, and this video is about the commonly asked questions in F1 visa interview and how to answer them. Make sure that you check out that video as well. And as a part of this video, we have a free document checklist. So this is a PDF which will tell you all the documents that you need to prepare for your F1 interview. This is because one of the common reasons why these visas get rejected is not having the documents in order. So make sure that you click on the link in the description box below and get your free PDF. So with all of this said, let's get started. So when you go to the interview, the visa officer will assume that you are a potential immigrant, and your job throughout the interview is to prove that you are not. So when your visa gets refused under section 221G, this means that the visa officer thinks that you are at a risk of immigration, that you will go to the US, you will complete your studies, and then you will end up settling there and not come back. It's very important to understand what are the reasons which lead to 221G rejection and how to avoid them, and we will discuss that right here. So the first reason for rejection is a low-ranking college. Now, it is not enough to just get admission in any college in the US or in any university. It also has to be worth the effort and the time that you're going to spend to come all the way to the US and also to spend all the money. So if you are applying to a really low ranked college or to a community college, then it's going to raise a doubt in the visa officer's mind. And he is going to ask you that, what is the point of studying in so and so college? Why not find a better college somewhere else? Or why not study in your home country itself? So make sure that you are extremely sure of the college that you're applying to. Do not just apply to any college and, you know, put it in your application. Whatever college that you're applying to, it has to fit into your profile, with your background, with your long-term plans, and more importantly, you should be able to justify why you want to study there in the visa interview. The second reason for rejection is the course not being in line with your background. So first we spoke about the college, next comes the course. So the course that you're planning to apply to, or the course that you want to study, has to be in line with the background that you come from and your future plans. So let's say that you have been an engineer for the last 15 years and now suddenly you want to do a course in fashion designing. Now, I'm not saying that this is not possible or that you shouldn't do it. Please go ahead by all means and do it if that's your interest. But again, you should be able to justify why this switch in the visa interview. And also, you should have sufficient proof to show that you have genuine interest in fashion designing and you have been doing other things to, you know, pursue your career or to pursue your interest in this particular field. So in the end, the takeaway from this is that the course that you're applying to should again fit into your profile. It should tie very well with the background that you have and the future plans that you have. The third reason for rejection is a better course available in the home country. Now keep in mind that the visa officer will be extremely well aware of the education system and the courses and the colleges in your home country, be it India or whichever else. So if you want to apply for a course which is better in your home country, there are better options available in your home country compared to the US, then he's going to ask you that, why are you doing this? Why not study this course in so-and-so college? What is the point of going all the way to the US and spending all this money? An example for this could be, say, a course in English speaking. Now, if you think about it, it does not make any sense for somebody to go from India to US to study English or take up a course in English speaking. There are many such options available back home in India. So you need to again keep in mind the course that you're applying to and whether it actually makes sense to go to the US to study this course. The fourth reason for rejection is your future plans. So during your interview, you will be asked, what are your future plans? What are your long-term plans? And if you show any indication that your future plan is to take up a long-term job in the US and to settle there and to not come back, then your visa will be rejected. Your long-term plans and your future plans need to be tied back to your home country. You are going there just as a student to study and nothing else. Another reason why F1 visas get rejected is when they go in administrative processing. Now, administrative processing essentially means that the visa officer is not fully convinced about your profile and he wants some more information to make the decision. It could be information about your background, it could be some more documents, and so on. And in my opinion, it is best to avoid getting into administrative processing because you have no control on the amount of time that it is going to take. It can take days, months, sometimes even a year. So there are two main reasons why F1 visas go into administrative processing. The first one is funding. Now, how you fund your education is an extremely important aspect of F1 visa interviews, and this is something that you can expect to be asked. So you need to know what is the total expense of this course, what is the breakup, and how exactly you're going to fund it. Now, during the interview, if he finds that your funding is not in place or you do not have the relevant documents to support the funding that you have shown in your form, then the visa can go into administrative processing and the visa officer can tell you that, okay, you submit all these additional documents and then we'll take a decision. The second reason is missing transcript, degrees and other generic documents. So you are expected to carry all your transcripts, all your degree certificates, even if it is provisional to you. It is not generally asked in the F1 interviews, but sometimes the visa officer can pull up and ask for these documents. And again, if you do not have them in place, if you do not have proof for the degree that you have shown in your profile, he can ask you to submit this and, you know, check back later. Basically, it is best to be thoroughly prepared with all the documents that you might need during the visa interview. And just to help you out in this, we have prepared a document checklist. This is a free PDF download. It is there in the description box below. So do click on that link and get your PDF. So now that we have discussed all possible reasons for rejection, I want to share some insider tips with you. And these are essentially from my experience of helping students clear the F1 visa interview. The first one is that you need to be extremely well prepared and you need tons of practice. So you need to be very well prepared for the answers that you're going to give. A lot of research, a lot of thinking, and a lot of time has to go into preparing these answers. And more importantly, you need to practice these answers. Don't just keep it in your mind and think that it'll come to you on the day of the interview. Practice it by writing it, by saying it in front of a mirror, or in front of somebody else. If you're interested, you can take a mock interview with me. This will be done on a video call, and this will be a one-to-one interview where, you know, you will go through the drill and you will get the feel of an actual visa interview. The link for this is in the description box below. Do check it out. The second tip I have for you is that you need to be extremely honest. I cannot tell you how many times people have lost out on visa interviews because of not being honest or because of trying to say something that was not true. The visa officers are extremely well trained to catch lies, to, you know, judge a person's personality. This is something that they go extensive training in. So do not even think of flipping, of lying, or of saying something that you haven't done, or, you know, of putting something in your resume which is not true. Completely avoid all this. Be 100% honest. Whatever it is, whatever are your intentions, whatever is the reason that you've selected the college, be honest and be confident in saying that out. So these were all the reasons why F1 visas get rejected. I hope this has given you a fair idea about it. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below or DM me on Instagram. For more in-depth preparation, which is tailor-made to your profile, to your background, and to the college that you're applying to, you can book a consultation session with me. The link for this is in the description box below. So all the best for your interview. I really hope that you crack it and you're able to go and join the college of your dreams. Do stay tuned on this channel for more such useful videos. I'll see you in the next one. Signing off till then. Bye.